محمد. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين أبي القاسم محمد وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. First of all, I'd just like to say it's an honor to be driving here every day, about 30 minutes. I enjoy the ride coming up here, it's very reflective. Alhamdulillah, just to visit, you know, fellow Muslims. And we have to aid each other constantly, no matter how far, how close, doesn't matter. And tonight, as we're going to the first, the striking of Imam Ali alayhi salam, tonight and tomorrow, I wanted to really look into one aspect. I wanted to go with a journey with Imam Ali alayhi salam. And I wanted to dissect the way he would just have these transactions with people, how he would conduct himself. Just go to one story that we can take apart and listen, truly listen with our hearts, and take some foundations, take some principles that we can apply on everyday life. And I found a story that's so beautiful because it starts with anger from one person, but ends with the most beautiful, beautiful things. That he reverses this person's heart from complete anger. Then the person is actually getting to a point where they want. They're chasing him. How do we do that? How do we have this kind of aspect to ourselves? That we can take a person that's so angry with us, but we can flip them around completely. How? Subhanallah, we have personalities that can teach us this. But we just have to not just read the story, but look into it. Look further. Now, the story tonight, let's go with the journey with Imam Ali alayhi salam. After the battle at Nahrawan, Imam Ali was walking about. Now imagine, Imam Ali is the Khalifa of the time. Pretty much imagine a king running a kingdom. He has control over the whole land. Now imagine President Obama today. What would you have to go through just to get to him? Imagine the amount of security. You know when the cops pull up on the sides of the road and they start closing off the roads and you're wondering what's going on? Just the president is being what? Protected. The highways closed off. Imagine the precautions that are taken. Imam Ali is just walking about. He sees an older lady. I'm telling you, the story to me is profound. He sees an old lady. He comes up to her. He asks her. He says, "What are you doing?" She says, "I'm stirring some hot water." He says to her, "Why? Why are you doing that?" She says to him, she goes, "I'm pretending that I'm making a meal for my children. I'm pretending." He says to her, "Why are you doing that?" She goes, "My husband and my sons went to the battle of Nahrawan and were killed." She goes, "Ali ibn Abi Talib took them there. So now, imagine the situation that's being put in front of him." She says to him, furthermore, she goes, "If I ever were to see him," she goes, "I would curse him." She says, "God curse him." Now imagine, again, imagine this is the president. Imagine this is the Khalifa of the time. How would we react? I guarantee you, not many of us can hold our composure. Our pride would take over. And what would happen? We would react in the most impulsive ways. But Imam Ali alayhi salam says what? No, don't do that. He has another hadith. He says, Ya ayyuha al-sa'il. Ya ayyuha al-sa'il. He says, Istama'. First, listen. Thumma istafhim. Then understand. Thumma istayqin. Then he says, make sure it's the truth. But here, istama', thumma istafhim. How many of us get to these even two points? How many of us get to a point where before we understand anything, we react? I guarantee you, we would be in the first step, one and two. We would listen. As soon as we become prideful, we will react. We will not seek to understand. Guaranteed. Many of us would have this. But Imam Ali alayhi salam, what does he do? He keeps questioning. I swear to you, whenever I'm in a conversation, whenever I enter someone's presence, I count how many statements I make versus how many questions I ask. I count to myself. And if I'm making too many statements, I say, hold back, step back. You're making too many statements. Question. Imam Ali has entered the presence of this lady. She's got a blameful heart. The heart is hurt. She's blaming the caliph that took them there. Now, let's look further into this. Please, what I'm about to say, try to take it in. Because we all go through this. And it's implicit, meaning it's subconscious. We don't realize we are doing it. When we blame others, here's what happens. She has never met Imam Ali alayhi salam. Never met him. Now she's accusing him because she has lost who? Her sons. Does she have a right? Sure. Absolutely. Does she have the context? Does she have the situation? Does she know of the situation and how they died? No. She doesn't know. What is the first thing when someone blames us? What do we do? Pay attention to this. What do we do? The first thing we do is we put forth excuses. That's the first thing we do. We put forth excuses. Why? Because usually we're looking at our own situation. We're trying to explain the situation to the other person. This is so crucial. When someone blames us, so number one, when you blame someone, don't attribute it to their personality right away. Look at their situation. Number one, it's the first principle. Number two, if we are being blamed, Imam Ali alayhi salam says what? Don't start putting forth excuses. This is what most people do. بَلْ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِهِ لَبَصِيرًا وَلَوْ أَلْقَى مَعَذِيرًا. Even to Allah, we're going to put forth our excuses. If you don't repair any situation, this is what we will do. We will attribute to the personality. Let me give you a quick example. Somebody cuts you off. You're in traffic, somebody cuts you off. What's the first thing you do? You blame the personality. You blame the person. You don't look at their situation. Maybe his wife is about to give birth right next to him and he had to cut you off. Do you give him that kind of excuse? No. But what does the Prophet say to us? The Prophet says, give your believing brother what? How many excuses? 70. Why? Please ask yourself why. Why would the Prophet ask us to do that? Because the Prophet, once you start doing that, you start looking at the situation of the person. You start giving excuses looking at the situation. You start saying to yourself, look, this person may have this issue. It may be this problem. You start giving excuses for the person based on their situation. You don't look at the personality anymore. SubhanAllah. Look at the antidote of the heart. This is what our Prophet teaches us. This is what Imam alayhi salam, Imam Ali alayhi salam teaches us. So Imam Ali alayhi salam does not give her excuses. He says to her, she says, if I ever were to see him, I would curse him. He says to her, you would curse him? Wow. Subhanallah. Again, does he have the right to come back and say, you know, but the situation was this, 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 and this? Absolutely. He doesn't do that. He steps back and he says to her, how can I help you? Subhanallah. This is what gets to my heart. He says, how can I help you? So now he wants to serve. This is the transition. This is the transaction of shifting someone's heart from anger to what? To mercy. This is incredible if you study it. A person's heart is hardened, and for a great reason, but it may be based on ignorance. She may not understand, but now the healing process begins. He's studying the heart. Now he's first what? What's the first thing? He's asked. He's questioned to understand the situation properly. When he has done that, he does not react with pride. He stepped back. Then he starts looking and studying emotionally. Where's this person's heart? Look, this is a psychologist. I swear to you, it's incredible. Now he begins to apply the antidote. She says to him, she goes, I don't know you. She goes, it's a kind gesture, but just let it be. He says, please, let me serve you. She said, please, I don't know you. He says, he insists, and he says, let me serve you. So every day now in the morning, he brings bread, the dough for the bread, and he starts helping her. Look at the transaction. He asked her before, he said, your children, how did they get fed? She goes, my daughter is with her in-laws and she's no longer here with me. I have no means. So now he tells her, let me serve you. So now Imam Ali alayhi salam is serving her. She would ask him, how can I repay you? He said, just pray to Allah. Pray to Allah for me. In anything that I have done, imagine that, please, seriously, take a look at your own heart. How many of us would do stuff like this? Do you blame us for following a man like this? Would you? The heart should move. Your heart should move. It should connect to a personality like that. Why? Because this is the way I want to be. I wish I can be in this man's shoes. That my heart can hold itself. And then it can push itself in the right time, in the right place. It's not easy. It's not easy for us to do. So now, he gets to a point where every day in the morning, he's servicing her. And he's applying the antidote. And one day, the daughter comes. And as he was leaving, subhanallah, Allah says, وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. Look, does he ever use his tongue? Does he ever say to her, I am the Khalifa? Does he ever present himself in any which way? How many of us just want the prizes of recognition? We want to put that picture on Facebook so people can hit that like button. We want to be liked by everyone. But Imam Ali alayhi salam is telling you what? Be careful. We want others to praise us. We want that recognition. Does Imam Ali want the recognition? Does he? Absolutely not. Why? Because the heart is connected not to Facebook, it's connected to Allah Azza wa Jal. That's different. There's no other gratification that a person can gain in terms of how happy they can feel when the heart is connected there. Subhanallah. My security is not dependent on others hitting the like button. It's depending how Allah likes my actions. Salla ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
So now, the daughter is leaving. I'm sorry, Imam Ali is leaving. The daughter is coming. She sees and she recognizes Imam Ali alayhi salam. Now, subhanAllah, take this into your own account. Do things in secret. When you do things in secret, it will turn your system inside out. Meaning, your system internally, you will have such strong character that people, without you saying anything, because of your own personality, they will know that you have given. SubhanAllah, without you opening a word. When you do that, and your character can emit these kinds of qualities, this is what happens. So now, he's leaving. The daughter's coming. She recognizes him. When she recognizes him, she goes into the house. She says, "Oh mother, did you see who just left our home?" She goes, "Yes." The mother goes, "Yes." She goes, "What a great man. What a dignified man that man is." She goes, "You don't know who he is?" She says, "I've never asked him his name." SubhanAllah. Again, have a triangular system. Meaning, you, Allah, then the other person. A lot of times in life, we want the what? Me, you equation. No. But believe me, when you have a triangular system between you, Allah, and the other person, there's no way you can give as much as Allah can give. When you connect to Him first, what bounties may be fall on the other person may be a lot greater than your own capabilities can ever give. When your heart is connected to Allah, that's the most powerful thing. So now, she tells him, that's the Khalifa. That's the one who runs this whole land. Imagine the heart of that lady now. She was cursing him. He applied the medicine. And what happened? Now she runs after him. How many of us can do that? This is so powerful to me. How a person can take a person that's so angered by him and what? Apply the right medicine to heal the heart that the person now is chasing you. How? That's incredible. So now she reaches him and she says to him, she says, "I'm sorry, I didn't know who you are." The Imam says, imagine again a king or a president. Would they have this kind of demeanor? Look across time. Does anybody have what we have? No. Let's not take this man for granted. This man is living with you every single moment. Let him resonate in your heart. If that happens, you have held on to the most powerful things on the face of this earth. Believe me, no other conduct can come close to this man. So now he replies and he says to her, he says, "Please, please pray to Allah that if I have done anything wrong, please pray to Him." SubhanAllah. Again, how many of us would have this kind of courage and this kind of psychology and emotional understanding of the other person? Most of us, we get to a point where we're so angry, we cannot even see in front of us. So please, the next time, what are we going to do? Let's run the script. We're going to ask questions more than we give answers. When we ask questions, we're going to analyze the situation. Then we're going to look at an emotional level. Where's the other person's heart? Then we're not going to react. Then we're going to apply, because we understood the situation, we're going to apply the right medicine with kindness and mercy that the other person's heart can melt in your hand. This is the application of Imam Ali alayhi salam. Wa sallu ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.